This is the Carib World News. I am Clifton James. We begin in Trinidad. Radio announcer Andy Williams was ambushed and shot at his Chaguanas home at daybreak Monday. Williams was shot 4 times by 2 men armed with firearms who confronted him in the garage of his home at Edinburgh 500. Around 5:45 a.m., Williams, 43, was retrieving his garbage bin from the street and returning into the house when gunmen confronted him. The gunmen fired off multiple rounds and Williams was hit to the back and arm. Police said they have not uncovered a motive for the shooting attack. In Antigua, a 21-year-old has been sentenced to 1 year in jail for having unlawful sexual intercourse with a 13-year-old girl who he claimed was his girlfriend. Grace Farm resident was sentenced by Justice Ian Morley on Monday after he pleaded guilty to the offence. The convict reportedly met the complainant in March 2019 and, according to the young girl, he was her boyfriend. The facts of the case as presented in court state that on the evening of May 22, 2019, the man invited the girl to a house. There, in the bedroom, he began to touch the child intimately and proceeded to have sex with her. When the victim arrived home, she was asked about her whereabouts and confessed what had happened. A report was made to Grace Farm Police Station and the minor was examined. The man was subsequently charged with the offence, which carries a maximum sentence of life imprisonment. The judge considered several factors and concluded that the man should spend 12 months in jail, a portion of which was reduced as he had pleaded guilty. He had already spent 6 months on remand and will therefore only have to spend 2 months in prison. In Jamaica, police detectives are now combing through sections of Sherwood Forest in eastern Portland following the discovery of a body of the wife of a prominent businessman. Police sources say the body of Tonya MacDonald, wife of businessman Everton Beachy Stout MacDonald, was discovered shortly after 9 p.m. on Monday. The throat was slashed and the body partially burnt. The incident happened more than 10 kilometres from Dolphin Bay, where the woman lived. The police theorised that the woman was abducted, murdered, and then the car set ablaze. In May 2009, MacDonald's first wife, Merlene, was gunned down outside her gate at Book Brown near the entrance to Springback Road. The United States has ordered the closure of China's consulate in the city of Houston, a move Beijing called an unprecedented escalation that will sabotage relations between the two countries. In a statement on Wednesday, Morgan Ortega's spokeswoman for the United States Department of State said Washington directed the consulate's closure in order to protect American intellectual property and America's private information. Washington's order comes as the two countries clash on a wide range of issues, from trade to the coronavirus pandemic and China's policies in Hong Kong, Xinjiang and the South China Sea. A new Netflix show about an Indian matchmaker catering to the high demands of potential brides and grooms and their parents has stoked an online debate about arranged marriages in the country. The 8-part series Indian Matchmaking premiered on Netflix last week and is currently among its top-ranked Indian shows. It features Seema Taparia, a real-life matchmaker from Mumbai, who offers her services to families in India and abroad. Arranged marriages in India are mostly guided by parents who want to find a suitable match for their children. The show has become the subject of memes, jokes and criticism about the pickiness of the potential spouses and their parents, with a long list of demands centering around factors like caste, height or skin colour. The show makes very clear how regressive Indian communities can be, where sexism, casteism and classism are a prevalent part of the process of finding a life partner. When authorities started planting millions of trees in eastern Pakistan's Changa Manga forest 5 years ago, the idea was to bring back life to forest land that had been destroyed by illegal logging, water scarcity and fires. Now that the trees have matured, they have an even sweeter side effect. helping to boost the local bee population and honey production in the area. As part of Pakistan's efforts to offset the impacts of climate change by rehabilitating forests, conserving soil and improving water management, 3.5 million trees were planted on 6,000 acres in Changamanga, known as one of the world's largest man-made forests near the city of Lahore. Beekeepers in the plantation said they are now harvesting up to 70% more honey than before, greening projects starting in 2014, as the trees provided a habitat for bees and create conditions for a growing diversity of plants and flowers. According to Forest Officer Shahid Tabusam, the daily amount of sticky stuff coming out of Changamanga is estimated to keep rising to about 2,000 kilos in the next fiscal year. Malik Amin Aslam, climate advisor to Prime Minister Imran Khan, said that nurturing the relationship between trees and bees is a priority for the 10 billion trees project. You're up to date. Carib World News. For local flights, contact CaribJet 439 4444 or caribjet.com.